Let us see decimal representation of a rational numbers. Now, a rational number can be represented in decimal format. A rational number can be represented in decimal form. Now, when we convert a rational number into a decimal form, there are two types. One is terminating decimal and non-terminating recurring decimal. Terminating decimal, non-terminating recurring decimal. Recurring decimal or repeating decimal. Now, we'll see some rational numbers here. If I say 1 by 2, 1 by 3, say 5 by 4, 1 by 5, 1 by 6, so on if I take 1 by 10. If you observe these rational numbers, I want to convert these rational numbers into decimal form. First, we'll see how to convert 1 with a decimal. 1, if you this is numerator, this is denominator. The numerator 1, I am dividing with denominator 2. Now, 1 will not go 0.25010. And if you convert in the same way, 1 by 3 into a decimal format, that is 3 threes are 9, 1 again 0, 3 threes are 9, 1, will take 0 here, 3 threes are 9, 1, it continues. So, like this, if I write 5 by 4 as a decimal form, we'll get 1.25, and if I write 1 by 5 as a decimal form, we'll get 0.2, 1 by 6 if I write as a decimal form, we'll get 0.666, and so on. If I, once we'll check, 1 by 7, if you write in a decimal form, what we will get? 1, I'm dividing with 7, 0.7, 1's are 7, 3. Now, decimal is there, I will take 0 here, 7 4's are 28, 2, 0, 7 2's are 14, 6, 0, 7 8's are 56, 4, 0, 7 5's are 35, 5, 7 7's are 49, 1 will get. Now, this 1 again is repeating. Again, if I take 0 here, 1, 7, again 4, 28, it repeats. Means I can write this as 0.142857, 142857, so on. Now, if you see here, 1 by 2 I got as 0.5, 1 by 3 as 0.333, it will not end, it will continue. 5 by 4 as 1.25, 1 by 6 as 0.666 and it will continue, 1 by 7 as 0.14857, 142857, it will continue again 142857. And if I write 1 by 10, 0.1, like this, once we will write all this in a decimal form. Now, after the division, the rational numbers, we got 1 by 2 as 0.5, 1 by 3 we got it as 0.333, so on, 5 by 4 we got it as 1.25, 1 by 6 we got it as 0.666, so on. And 1 by 7 we got 0.142857, 142857, so on, and 1 by 10 is 0.1. Like this we can see more examples also, but if you observe these examples here, when we are dividing a 1 with 2, I am getting a remainder 0. Means when we are dividing numerator with a denominator, in that division, if I get the remainder 0, we will call, and it is terminating, and here the decimal part is finite, then we will call that one as terminating decimal. If you observe that 1 by 2, 5 by 4 and 1 by 10, these are, when we are dividing a numerator with a denominator, it is getting reminder, it is giving a reminder 0 and the decimal part is finite. Therefore, these are called terminating decimals. But if you observe 1 by 3, 1 by 6, 1 by 7, now here the division process never ends, it is continuing. I am not getting the remainder as 0 and it is not ending also. The number it is repeating and it is not terminating. Those type of decimals are called as non-terminating recurring decimal. Non-terminating, it's not ending the division, and recurring because 3 is repeating. Here 3 is repeating, here 6 is repeating, here 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7 is repeating. Therefore, these decimals are called non-terminating recurring decimal. Means every rational number can be represented as either terminating decimal or non-terminating recurring decimal. But if you observe here in the non-terminating recurring decimal, here the number which is repeating, which number is repeating here? 3. The number which is repeating is called as period. And how many numbers are repeating here? 3 is repeating, means one number is repeating. How many numbers are repeating? That is called periodicity. And if you observe 1 by 6, here which number is repeating? 6. Therefore, 6 is period, and how many numbers are repeating here? One number. Therefore, 1 is periodicity. And if you observe here 1 by 7, 0.142857, 142857, here 142857 is period. How many numbers are repeating here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 numbers are repeating. Therefore, the periodicity is 6. See here, a rational number can be represented as a decimal form. The decimal form may be terminating decimal or non-terminating recurring decimal. Now, if it's in terminating decimal, we'll get the remainder 0 and the decimal part is finite. In the non-terminating recurring decimal, the denominator is not 0 and the decimal part is infinite. And if you observe the non-terminating decimal number, here the number which is repeating is called period. How many numbers are repeating? That is called periodicity of the number. If you observe 1 by 7 here, 0.142857 is repeating. Therefore, 142857 is called period. And how many numbers are repeating? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 is a periodicity of that number. Now, if I take two rational numbers, and if you we can observe one more thing here. Now, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, these same rational numbers will take, and what we are can say about the terminating and non-terminating, we'll see once. 1 by 2, I'm writing as 0.5. 1 by 3, after the division, we got it as 0.333, so on. The same thing, we can represent it as 0.3 bar also. What is meaning of this? The number 3 is repeating and it never ends. And 1 by 4, we are writing as, actually we took the example 5 by 4. Even 1 by 4, we can write as 0.25. 1 by 5, we can write it as 0.2. 1 by 6, we can write as 0.666, so on, that is 0.6 bar. And 1 by 7, we are writing as 0.142857. 142857, simply I can, it's non-terminating, 0.142857 bar. Now, if you observe, or 1 by 10 also will take, that is 0.1, so on, it continues. Now, here if you observe 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 10, these are the terminating decimals. What is meaning of this? It is having a finite decimal part. Now, without doing the actual division, can I conclude that the given rational number is a terminating decimal or non-terminating decimal? If you observe the examples here, even 1 by 5 is also terminating here. If you observe the example of terminating decimal, observe the denominator here, 2, 4, 5 and 10. Now, the denominator of a rational number if I am able to write as a product of, in the simplest form, the denominator of a simplest fraction means if I write it as 3 by 6, what is the simplest form of 3 by 6? 1 by 2. The standard form of a rational number, in that if I see the denominator, if the denominator, if I am able to write as a product of prime factors, product of prime factors, it contain only 2 or 5 or both 2 and 5, then only we can say that is a terminating decimal. Means, now this is the simplest form of a rational number. If you observe the denominator here, the denominator is 2. The prime, in the prime factorization, what is the prime factor? 2. Here the prime factor of 4, if I write as a prime factors, I will write as 2 into 2, 5. And here 10, what we will write? 5 into 2. Means, in the simplest form or standard form of a rational number, if I take, if the denominator contains 2 or 5 as a prime factors, then that rational number is a terminating decimal. Again, I'll repeat. In the simplest form or standard form of a rational number, if I see the denominator, if a denominator I'm able to write as a product of 2 or 5 as a prime factors, then we'll say that decimal, that rational numbers are terminating decimals. The denominator which do not contain or including 2 and 5, feet, other than 2 and 5, feet, has any other factor, then we'll call it as non-terminating repeating decimal. If you see here, 3 is a prime factor. In the 5, 5 is a prime. Here 6, 3 into 2. Even though 2 is a prime factor, other than 2 or 5, it is 3 is also a prime factor, then it is not a terminating decimal, it is non-terminating recurring decimal. Means, a rational number can be represented as a decimal form. The decimal form is terminating decimal, non-terminating decimal. Without doing the actual division, how we can decide whether it is a terminating or non-terminating? If a denominator in the simplest form or a standard form of a rational number, if I am able to write as a product of prime factors, that prime factors to be 2 or 5, a combination of 2 and 5, then only the rational number is terminating decimal, otherwise the rational number is non-terminating decimal. And in between two rational numbers, there exist infinite rational numbers. Suppose if I take any two numbers, 4 or 5, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, in between two rational numbers, there exist uncountable rational numbers. This property is known as property of density. In what is this property is known as? Property of density. What is mean by property of density? In between two rational numbers, there exists uncountable rational numbers. That property is known as property of density. Now, how to find out the rational numbers in between two rational numbers? Before going to that, whatever the topic we have discussed, once we see some of the challenges in that. Now, if I give a fraction as 1 by 7, a rational number 1 by 7, now, we have to decide that whether it is a terminating decimal or non-terminating decimal. 1 by 7. Now, this is the simplest form of a rational number. If you observe the denominator is 7. So, the 7 is not having the prime factors either 2 or 5. Therefore, it is what type of decimal? Non-terminating recurring decimal. Non-terminating recurring decimal. Already we have seen this 1 by 7 example also before. Now, if I take minus 15 by 4. Now, if you observe this, it is already in the simplest form. What is the prime factors of 4? 2 square. Means, the denominator is having a prime factor as 2. Therefore, it is a terminating decimal. It is a terminating decimal. If you observe also, after division, we'll come to know that it's a terminating decimal. See, observance 15 divided with 4, 4 3s are 12, 0, 4 7s are 28, 2, 0, 4 5s are 20. Now, the remainder I'm getting 0 and it is terminating here. Therefore, minus 15 by 4, I can write it as minus 3.75. Means, without doing this actual division, by observing the denominator only, we can decide whether it is a terminating or non-terminating. And we'll see one more example here, 26 by 28. Take an example of 26 by 28. Now, is it in a standard form? 26 and 28, the number is here ending with 6, here ending with 8, compulsory it has a common factor of 2. First convert into your simplest form, 2 ones, 2 threes, 2 ones, 2 fours. We can write this as equivalent fraction of 13 by 14. Now, this is in the standard form of a rational number. Now, if you observe this, what is the denominator here? The denominator is 14. Now, 14 can be write as a prime factors, that is a product of prime factors 7 into 2. Other than 2, it has a prime factor 7. Therefore, 13 by 14 is what? Non-terminating recurring decimal. Non-terminating recurring decimal. Non-terminating recurring decimal. Next, second problem, express each of the following in a decimal form. Now, any rational number, if you want to express in a decimal form, just numerator divide with denominator, 2 threes are 6, 1, 2 fives are 10, remainder is 0, so 7 by 2, I can write as 3.5. And one more example, we'll see that is minus 2 by 5. Now, what is minus 2 by 5? I'll take first 2 divide with 5, so 2 will not go in 5 table, 0.5 fours are 20. So, minus 2 by 5 will write as minus 0.4. And next, one more example, that is 156 by 20. First, now we'll see that whether we can write in a non-terminating decimal, recurring or terminating decimal. Now, is it in the simplest form? No, because here the number is ending with 6, here the number is ending with 0, compulsory it will go in 2 table, 2 tens, 2 sevens are 14, 2 eights. Again it will go in 2 table because it is ending with 0 and here it is ending with 8. 2 threes and 2 nines, 2 5. Now here 39 by 5. Now in the prime, in the denominator 5 we have, so the prime factor 5 it has, we can say it is a terminating decimal. And if you divide, if you want to write as a decimal form also, 5 sevens are 35, 4.5 eights are 40. So I can write 156 by 20 is equal to 7.8. Next, come to the property of density. I already said that in between two rational numbers, there exists uncountable rational numbers, that is called property of density. Now we'll see how to find out a rational number between two rational numbers. There are many procedures to find out a rational number between two rational numbers, but today we are going to discuss about three procedures. First we'll see procedure one. Now, if I want to find out a rational number between two rational numbers, suppose if A, B are two rational numbers, if I want to find out the rational number between A and B, now the mean is always lies between A and B. Therefore, what is the mean of this? A plus B by 2 means A plus B by 2 is a rational number between A and B. Now, A plus B by 2, B. Now again, if I want to find out the rational number, suppose I say that one rational number in between A and B, what I will do, I will divide A plus B by 2 and I will say A plus B by 2 is a rational number in between A and B. But if I want to find out the rational number, three rational numbers between A and B, see here, A plus B by 2 is a rational number between A and B. Now again in between these two, I can say A plus B by 2 by 2 is one rational number, and between these two, A plus B by 2 plus B by 2 is one more rational number. Like this, the processor continues to find out the rational numbers between two rational numbers. Again, repeat, procedure 1 is, if I want to find out the rational numbers between A and B, the mean is always exists in between. Therefore, what is rational number between A and B? A plus B by 2. This is one rational number. If I want to find out more than one rational number, that procedure, I'll repeat it. Here, A and A plus B by 2, A plus B by 2 by 2, and in between A plus B by 2 plus B by 2. Once we'll take an example for this problem. Here, suppose if I want to find out the rational number between 4 and 5, 4 plus 5 by 2, that is 9 by 2, which is equal to 4.5, it lies between 4 and 5. This again, a plus b by 2, a plus b by 2, we can continue. This is the procedure 1. Now, what is the procedure 2? If I want to find out the rational numbers between two rational numbers, procedure 2 is, if a comma b are the two rational numbers, if I want to find out the rational numbers between these two, how you will find out means, I will make the, suppose if it is a rational numbers having a denominator a by c, b by d, I will make the denominators equal, then I will find out how many rational numbers I want in between. Now, already we discussed how to make the denominators equal. We'll take the LCM of denominators and we'll make by multiplying a some number with the numerator and denominator, we'll equate the denominators and we'll find out the rational numbers in between. Let us see the example for this procedure. That is, if I take this example 1 by 4 and 1 by 3, if I want to find out the rational numbers in between 1 by 4 and 1 by 3, now I want to make the denominators equal. Now, what is the LCM for 4 and 3? 4 and 3 LCM is 4, 1, 3, 3. So, LCM of 4 and 3 is 12. Now, I want to make the denominator 12 here. With 4, with what number I should multiply to get 12? 4 I should multiply with 3 to get 12. Therefore, 1 by 4, I will write the equivalent fraction. That is, numerator and denominator, both I will multiply with 3, will get 3 by 12. And 1 by 3, to make the denominator as 12, with what number we have to multiply? 4. So, the numerator and denominator both I will multiply with 4, we will get 4 by 12. Now, in between 3 by 12 and 4 by 12, if you are not able to decide what number we have to write, make the equivalent fractions, means increase the denominator. Now, I will multiply with 2, that is 3 into 2, 12 into 2, 4 into 2, 12 into 2. So, what we will get here? 6 by 24, 8 by 24. Now, clearly we can say that in between 6 and 7 by 8 by 24, there exists a rational number 7 by 24. Suppose, instead of one rational number between 1 by 4 and 1 by 3, if I want to write 3 or more than 3 or 2 or more than 2, what you have to do? Still, I am going to increase the denominator. Here, 3 by 12, 4 by 12 is there. I am not able, actually in between these two also, there exists uncountable rational numbers. Suppose, if you are not able to identify what rational number we should write, what we are doing here? We are increasing the denominator by 2 by 2 and I am able to identify clearly that 7 by 24 exists between 6 and 6 by 24 and 8 by 24. Now what I am doing, I want to make two rational numbers in between. So instead of 2, I will multiply with 3 and I will divide with 3, I will multiply with 3 and divide by 3. 36, 4 threes are 12, 12 threes are 36. Now in between, I can write 10 by 36, 11 by 36. Now, I could able to write two rational numbers clearly. Actually, there exists infinite number of rational numbers, but clearly I am able to observe two. Suppose if you want to make three rational numbers, instead of three, we will multiply with 4 by 4, 4 by 4. The process will continue. This is the second procedure to find out the rational numbers in between two rational numbers. The procedure one is, we are finding out the mean between that. That's 1 by 4 and 1 by 3. Adding and dividing with 2, we are going to find out the rational number in between. According to the procedure 2, what we are doing? We are making the denominators equal and we are finding out the rational numbers in between, how many you want. And the denominator after making equal, we are not able to identify that exactly what number is lies between. Then we are increasing the denominator and we are finding out the rational numbers in between. Now, the procedure 3 is, now, procedure 3, what I will do here, I will convert the given rational numbers into decimal form, what we have learned before. Then I will decide what rational numbers are in between. Now, 1 by 4 is a terminating decimal, right? 1 by 4, what we will get? 0.25 if you divide it. And 1 by 3 is 0.333, so on. Now, in between, if I want to write the rational numbers, you can write as many you want, 0.256, 0.26. 0.2566, like that, how many numbers you want to insert, you can insert that. Now, we'll take one problem and we'll apply all the three procedures to find out the rational numbers in between those two rational numbers. Let us take example 2 and 3. I want to write the rational, we'll take a rational number instead of integers, 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. Now, I want to write one rational number in between 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. According to the procedure 1, according to the procedure 1. Now, what is the procedure 1? When I want to write a rational number in between two rational numbers, I'll add those two rational numbers and I'll divide by 2. That is 2 by 3 plus 3 by 4 by 2. Means, here already we have learned that addition of rational numbers. How you'll add the rational numbers? The LCM for 3 and 4 is 12. 3 how many times will go? 4 times. 4 into 2 plus 4 3 times will go. 3 3 so 9 by 2. Here for 2 there is no denominator. I can write as 2 by 1 because 2 by 1 is also a rational number. I can write it as 2 by 1. 4 2 is 8 plus 3 3 is 9 by 12 into 1 by 2. That is 8 plus 9 is what? 17 by 12 into 2, 24. Means 17 by 24 is a rational number which lies in between 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. So, according to the procedure 1, we got 17 by 24, a number which we have infinite rational numbers. One rational number we are finding out in between, that is 17 by 24 we got. Now, we will see the procedure 2 now. What is the procedure 2? According to the procedure 2, we'll make the denominators equal and we'll find out the rational numbers in between. That is 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. What is the LCM for 3 and 4? 12. So, 2 by 3, how can you make it into 12 by multiplying with 4? So, 4 by 4, 3 by 4 into 3 by 3, 8 by 12, 9 by 12. Clearly, I am not able to decide what number it is in between. Therefore, I will multiply again with 2 by 2, 2 by 2. Then what happens here? 16 by 24, 18 by 24. Then there exists a rational number in between 17 by 24. Don't think that only this rational numbers will exist in between. There are uncountable rational numbers between these two. But we are writing 17 by 24 is also in between. So, according to the procedure 2 also, 17 by 24 is in between these two rational numbers. Now, if I want to apply the procedure 3, I will convert into decimal format and I will write whatever the numbers you want. 2 by 3. Now, 2 by 3, if I want to convert into decimal format, 3 6 are 18, 2, 3 6 are 18, 2. Like this, it will continue. So, I can write this as 0.666666 so on. And 3 by 4 is 3 dividing with 4. 4 7s are 28. 2 4 5s are 20. 0.75. In between, I can write 0.7, 0.71, 0.711, 0.72. Like this, any numbers you can write it. So, not even this for 3 procedure, we have many procedures to find out the rational numbers in between the 2 rational numbers. But these are 3 procedures, any one of them can follow. Today we have discussed only 3 procedures to find out the rational numbers in between 2 rational numbers. Next, find the 3 rational numbers between 4 and 5. Now, between 4 and 5, I want to find out 3 rational numbers. So, between 4 and 5, 3 rational numbers means, if I want to convert in a decimal format, I can write 4.1, 4.2, 4.3. Like that, I can write any numbers. But here, as 3 rational numbers, I can say according to the procedure 3, 4.1, 4.2, 4.3. And according to the procedure 1, 4 plus 5 by 2, that is 9 by 2, 4.5. Again, 4 plus 4.5 by 2, that is 9.5 by 2 and 4.5 plus 5 by 2, that is 9.5 by 2. Like this we can write according to the procedure 1 and procedure 2 also we can apply. I'll multiply and divide with 5 by 5, suppose 4 by 5 into 5, 5 by 5 into 5, then we'll get 20 by 5. Here 25 by 5, I can write 21 by 5, 22 by 5 23 by 5 24 by 5, or if you want like this, you can write the decimal numbers in between 4 and 5. Now next we'll see some of the word problems related to the rational numbers. We'll see one example in the rational numbers, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division,